Anatomic Retro-apical Technique for synchronous posterior-anterior approach to apical transection during robotic radical prostatectomy. Many patients with prostate cancer choose to undergo radical prostatectomy. This procedure is safe and effective, but in some cases, patients are left with a positive surgical margin. The probability of positive surgical margins is greatest at the prostatic apex, making this the Achilles heel of prostate cancer surgery. While there have been several modifications and technical refinements to the prostate cancer surgery, positive surgical margins continue to be a troublesome setback. Reasons for apical positive surgical margins. The apex is the narrowest part of the prostate, lacking a true and well-defined capsule, so cancer is never too far from the surface. The apex is also the most inaccessible part of the prostate. Occasionally, a dorsal venous suture is not perfect, and there's an ongoing trickle of blood which further masks tissue recognition. Apical positive surgical margins occur primarily due to the surgeon's inability to differentiate between the prosthetic tissue, the dorsal venous complex, and the urethral sphincter. It is difficult to judge the thickness of the tissue, and therefore, small sections of the prosthetic apex may remain. These anatomic challenges can be overcome by deliberate cutting far from the prostate into the urethra and sphincter during the procedure. This technique is far from ideal because it either delays the return of continence or renders the patient permanently incontinent. Apical dissection may also put sexual nerves at risk as they converge close to the urethra at this location. A novel approach, anatomic retroapical technique. We approach the prostate-urethra junction from the posterior aspect of the urethra. Posteriorly, the urethra is only covered by denom biliaris fascia and the erector urethralis muscle. This is a clear path to the apex. Technical steps of anatomic retroapical technique. Following transection of the bladder neck, we identify the vas deferens and seminal vesicles. We mobilize the vas deferens and clip the proximal end behind the trigon. The distal vessa are grasped by the left side assistant and pulled anteriorly, tenting denom biliaris fascia. This fascia is incised in the midline, and the opening is enlarged laterally toward the medial edge of the pedicles. The undersurface of the prostate is identified, and a plane is developed within the layer of denom biliaris fascia. A cave-like space is created behind the prostate, and the dissection is deliberately extended distally to release the apex and the urethra from deeper tissue. Next, we release the neurovascular tissue using our trizonal neural hammock release technique and control arteries and veins as they enter the prostatic base. At this point, the prostate is mobile. It is lifted perpendicularly towards the anterior abdominal wall and pubic symphysis, affording a surprising level of clarity with which the white surface of the apex can be differentiated from the muscular urethra. Dissection of the superficial layers of denom biliaris fascia begins using sharp, curved scissors, exposing the precise prostate-urethral junction. Next, the posterior wall of the urethra is sharply incised 1 millimeter distal to the apex. The catheter is exposed and withdrawn through the posterior urethral opening. This also exposes the anterior wall of the urethral mucosa and the muscular wall. Using blunt and sharp dissections, the urethra is divided circumferentially. At this point, all the muscle fibers are transected and the DVC is left attached to the anterior surface of the prostate. Management of the DVC now depends on the width and thickness of the anterior tissue. If it is broad and thick, a DVC stitch with a CT1 needle and an O-polyglactin suture is utilized. The tissue is clinched using a slip knot. Alternatively, if the remaining tissue is thin, the pneumoperitoneum is increased and a Foley catheter balloon is inflated to 20-30 cc behind the prostate. The Foley is placed on traction, which partially occludes the DVC and opens up the space behind the prostate. The prostate is now grabbed and pulled cephalically. Switching to a 0-degree lens, anterior dissection is performed under a raised pneumoperitoneum. Using the robotic Marilyn grasper on the left and sharp scissors on the right, the DVC is transected distal to this point, often resulting in visible bleeding sinuses. Using these maneuvers, bleeding is minimized during DVC transection. The prostate is completely dissected with a 1 millimeter hood of ligaments and venous tissue still on the prosthetic apex. Results of anatomic retroapical technique. This technique has been used in 209 consecutive cases. We have studied its impact by calculating the incidence of positive apical surgical margin and comparing the rates to those of our previous 1,665 consecutive cases, where our approach was primarily an anterior one. Apical positive surgical margin rates dropped fourfold in the study cohort. 4.4% of the control group experienced apical positive surgical margins, while 1.4% of the study group experienced apical positive surgical margins. The overall positive surgical margin rates also decreased from the control group to the study group, from 9.8% to 5.26%, respectively. On multivariate analysis, preoperative serum PSA, percentage of positive cores, and retroapical techniques, were found to be significant predictors for positive apical surgical margin rates. Thus, our technique decreased the risk of positive surgical margins at the apex significantly. Potential benefits of anatomic retroapical technique. Neurovascular bundles are released out of harm's way before apical dissection. This results in better sexual function outcomes in our patients. The identification of the prostate urethral junction becomes very easy and precise. This approach allows us to gently push the posterior apical beak away from the sphincter, thus gaining a few extra millimeters of length. Therefore, we are able to preserve maximal length of the urethra. Several other key structures critical to urinary continence are also preserved, including the puboprostatic ligaments and arcus tendineus. This results in better continence outcomes. Since the prostate is free, early suturing of the DVC is not necessary, and sometimes balloon tamponade of the DVC obviates the need for suture prior to transection. It is important to note that our new surgical technique is not solely posterior, but is synchronous, involving a combination of posterior and anterior dissections. Conclusions of anatomic retroapical technique. We have developed a novel approach toward apical dissection which provides the surgeon with a circumferential view of the prostatic apex. We noted a fourfold reduction in the apical positive surgical margin rates of patients who underwent this surgical procedure, and the overall margin rates also dropped proportionally for these patients.